Hey guys, welcome back to a new video. Today, we are going to be showcasing this wonderful, wonderful suburban house. So, let's get started. This house has taken up a lot of my time recently because I really wanted to make sure that it was one of the most perfect builds that I could probably do. So, I put a lot of detail and a lot of effort into everything that goes into this build. So, outside we have this little porch couch and some hanging plants. That's basically the extent of it, and we just have some end rods on levers to act as lights. So I think that's a pretty cool design. When we first walk into the house, you see that there's a shag rug in the living room. I used the same design in my first suburban house, and I decided to use it here, but instead with deep slate, which really looks like a very modern stone kind of texture. As in the previous house, we also have a stack of wood in the corner to fuel the fireplace. Moving to the first bedroom, which is my favorite of the bunch, we have what I like to consider a gaming bedroom. You have all your LED panels on the sides, some soundboards, a mic, a keyboard, and your triple monitors with some speakers, and obviously a good mouse. In this corner, we have a bed and a little chair for some reading. Now we have the downstairs bathroom. The floor is made with copper, and we have another little rug when you get out of the shower slash bath just to dry your feet off, and we have some mirrors and obviously a toilet and some toilet paper. The roof, I used some looms because the bottom actually has a really interesting texture, and I used a beacon as a chandelier that was hanging from the ceiling. Moving on to this side of the house, this is the family room. You have a pretty modern little countertop table and a TV that's over there, and you have some speakers that you can listen to almost have like a surround sound speaker system. And in the corner, you have some bookshelves. Moving on to the dining room, this is a very grand dining room. You have some candles in the center with some napkins and plates and pots and everything. And obviously you have a little picture in the corner with some lamps, and this whole room is very aesthetic. From the living room, we actually move on to the kitchen. So you have two stovetops, which I used minecart furnaces for, which I've used a lot in many of my builds. And we actually use glow item frames, which you might have seen in my build hacks, to make it look like there's underlighting under the cabinets. Then we get to the drying and washing machine, which are just very simple. You have some hooks to hang up some clothes, and that's basically it. And now we could actually go downstairs to the garage, which houses this really, really amazing sports car. That was the first floor completed, so we're gonna move on upstairs. You're greeted with this desk with a little modern art piece on top of it, and then to the side you have a little greenhouse, which you could kind of tend to your plants even when you're indoors. We have a hallway bathroom, which is very, very small, but very cozy, so you have a little art piece on the side, and obviously your sink with a mirror and a towel, and all the stuff that you really need for a bathroom. The second bedroom of the house is over here. You have a nice bed with a little cover going across the bottom, and a little shelf with a plant and some souvenirs from various places. Over here you have a little corner desk with a laptop and a nice chair with a lamp in the corner, and obviously you have a lot of books. Now we enter the third bedroom of this house. We again have a bed and a little modern art piece over here. Again, we have some souvenirs and lighting, of course, and some more modern art kind of sprinkled around. But this is a really nice nook that you have over here where you could read all the books that you have over here, and you have this nice little kind of corner to read. I like this lamp design. I use sea pickles on top of end rods, and it actually looks really decent. Over here, obviously, we have our laptop, and you could just sit down and either do some assignments if you needed to, or, you know, play some Minecraft, because who doesn't want to do that? And as the last bedroom, we now get to the master bedroom. So here we have a slightly bigger bed, and we have some nice lighting. They have a TV in their room, and a little bamboo plant just in case they needed some greenery there, and obviously shelving for all of your shirts and pants and everything else that you would need. The bathroom has a really nice bath with a bath mat. You have a nice mirror with some drawers and towels on the walls. Over here you have a really nice toilet, again with the toilet paper design, which is actually an item frame with a white banner with a button in the same spot. You have a lamp, and again some modern art, and the shower, which actually shares a wall with the bath. I used a deep slate for a drain because I feel like it looks really nice. Again, a lot of this build was featured in my short, which came out recently. If you want, you can check that out. The link will be in the description. So yeah, check that out if you want to. But that is the actual full inside. Now we just have some outside things to look over. Going back to the front of the house, you could actually notice that it splits off into two directions, one that leads to the porch and one that leads in another direction. So let's go this way for a change. If we go all the way down, you can see some trinkets and the telephone wire going there, and it kind of leads down all the way to all these things. This is a timer or something of some kind, and you just have like almost like these gadgets and kind of trinkets everywhere. These are some recycling bins and garbage cans, just add more of like the actual feel that someone's living here, which I think actually really works and adds a lot of detail. Now we reach the backyard. You have a nice porch, which includes a table with an umbrella, and you have some nice seats to sit at, and a grill. This is my classic grill design that I've used in a lot of my builds, so yeah, it's actually very simple. And then we reach the area that you have a pool. I used grain coral and tuff to actually make up the floor, which looks very cobbled, and I think it really works in this. The pool is almost like a kidney bean, which actually is what a lot of pools look like these days, which is fun. But yeah, you have a diving board and some chairs to kind of just sit, and you have these nice tables that you could lay a drink on or just put anything on. Over here, similarly, we also have two chairs and a table where you could put things on inside this covered area. Well, that's the video. I really hope you guys enjoyed, and if you did enjoy, please make sure to subscribe because I'm planning on doing a lot more videos like these. So if you enjoyed, please make sure to subscribe and, you know, like the video if you enjoyed it. I just wanted to say a huge thank you to the massive support that I've been getting recently. I gained so many subscribers in the past month and a half. It's actually crazy. I can't thank you guys enough, and I really hope that you enjoyed this, and I'm planning on making a lot more content that I feel like you guys will be really excited for. So, thank you so much, have a good rest of your day or night, and I'll see you in the next video.